our days have gotten, like, there's not a lot of time for video games anymore. A hit song wasn't necessarily on our plate. We made a living off of being a live band. Probably, like, aside from making an album, everything else to us is just about the live show and making our fans happy and taking it really, really seriously as far as what we present, but also getting up on stage and just having a good time and making sure everybody is singing along. We want to play in as big a places as possible to as many people as possible. I think that nowadays it feels like ambition is frowned upon and looked at as being arrogant or something like that, but that's what we grew up on. We grew up on alternative music and bands like Pearl Jam and stuff like that, and you know, they just get bigger and bigger and people come and sing along, and that's what we want to do. So it's very interesting now because there will be maybe a pocket of people that have come to the shows. Fortunately, most of the shows sold out before any of that stuff happened, so it didn't feel like doesn't feel like we're just out there to play a song. It's already most of our fans. And then I've just spoken to people afterwards who are like, I came for the song, but oh my gosh, like what? Like everybody in the crowd is singing, and that's kind of the protocol for a fun show, is like you show up and you should know every single word. The way I write is interesting because I hear whole songs in my head. I don't play an instrument, so I have to kind of figure out what that song is and work it out enough times in my head to where it's not just like some random song, and I can start writing lyrics and whatnot. And so if it is like a full song and it feels kind of happy, like I still have to write lyrics, and generally I think of myself as a pessimistic optimist, and so that's just where all of the lyrics come from. And I never want the song to dictate the lyrics, because I've noticed that even the worst song in the world, as long as it has good lyrics, is still a pretty good song, because then it just ends up being a good poem, I suppose. The music video director, he was inspired by, if you go on YouTube and you see things like balloons popping in slow motion and stuff like that, he thought that was really cool, and we thought that was really cool, but we wanted some sort of physicality to it, so we all came up with having us play in the middle of just this insane bar fight. So we had a day to do it. The stunt people are insane. Like, they're constantly practicing beating each other up, like even in between takes and stuff like that, which I guess is their job, but it's kind of weird to stand around like amidst all this chaos. Andrew, our keyboard player, there's the palm tree that like flies out at him at some point during the video, and I remember watching from afar, and everything was shot in like quadruple time because it, you know, then it slowed down to slow motion or however the heck that type of stuff works. It's magic. And I just remember watching in like triple time, like this like palm tree flying at his face, and I was like, that's it, Andrew's done, like it's all over. And like he ducks, and I kind of just like he missed it just perfectly, and then you look back at the video and it's actually just like an incredible part when the palm tree is like flying at him while he's playing piano. And then there was one time where we did a full band scene and they were like, Nate, don't take a step back because we're gonna drop a disco ball and it's gonna break. And if you watch the video, you get all the way to the disco ball just about to hit the ground. And I thought that would be just like the most beautiful thing, but it just went like, it was so anticlimactic. It was just like, just kind of rolled off to the side. The name of the band, we were at a comedy club. We had like started demoing and writing music together, and we went through like a whole bunch of band names and we weren't feeling anything. And we went to a comedy club to go see a friend in New York. And afterwards he was like, all right guys, like let's figure out what this band name is gonna be. So we all sat around a table and like had dinner, and someone said Ice Cream. And it's the worst band name that I've ever heard in my whole entire life. So I like freaked out and I was like, no. But I like the image that it conjures up. And so someone else said Fun. And we sat on it for about 6 months. And in that time, like, we got a tour, so we had no choice but to like look at the list, and that was the only one that stood out.
So fun it is.
Fun it is. I can't, no turning back now.